Hi, I'm Max Dalton, and in this video, I'm going to talk through how to host your podcast MP3 on archive.org for free. The cost associated with hosting audio files for your podcast can start to add up fast. Almost all podcast hosting sites offer a free or very low-cost tier. While attractive, the downside to those options are that the max storage capacity is often very low, and the monthly bandwidth allocation for your podcast is often not very much. If you burn through the maximum storage space too fast, you'll need to pull down old episodes to make room for new episodes, which may not leave you with a large library for prospective listeners to listen to. Those lower allocations may force you to bump up to a higher cost tier before you're ready, and you may not even know if you want to keep doing your podcast. If you're just starting your podcast and are undergoing a sort of trial period, consider using a free hosting service such as archive.org. While archive.org doesn't have all of the user tracking bells and whistles of other podcast MP3 hosting sites, it does give you the following. 1. A reliable and safe place to host your podcast MP3s. 2. Unlimited storage space. And 3. Unlimited bandwidth. If you decide further down the line to host your podcast somewhere that tracks user data and also has a few more bells and whistles, that transition is an easy one to make. Now, the steps to host your podcast at archive.org. 1. You must have the final MP3 file you want to use as your podcast. Step 2. Open your web browser and navigate to archive.org. If you don't have an account at archive.org, you'll need to set one up. Setting up an account is free. Step 3. Click the Upload button in the upper right corner of the archive.com website. This will appear immediately to the left of the avatar associated with your image, if you supplied one. The Share Your File screen appears. Step 4. Click the green Upload Files button. A window appears that says Drag and Drop Files Here. Step 5. Drag your final podcast MP3 into the Drag and Drop Files window, and then release the file. Step 6. An information entry screen appears. This is where you'll enter a title for your file, where you can modify the URL at archive.org that will be associated with the file, a description, tags, Creative Commons license, and more. As a podcaster, the field you should care most about is the URL field. The URL is what the podcatcher will pick up from your podcast RSS feed, and most podcatchers won't list a podcast where it sees foul language in the URL. Step 7. Click the blue Upload and Create Your Item button at the bottom of the information entry screen when you're done supplying information. The MP3 file will now appear in your archive.org library, which can be accessed by clicking your avatar in the upper right corner of your screen and then clicking My Library. Step 8. Click the MP3 file associated with your podcast you just uploaded to bring up the information screen for that particular file. Step 9. Right-click VBR MP3 to open a context menu and then click Copy Link Address. Paste that address into a text editor. The URL you just pasted into a text editor is the URL you'll set inside of the enclosure link in the site post that will be associated with this episode of your podcast. Now, the downside to hosting your podcast at archive.org. Archive.org doesn't provide any analytics for your podcast. It will take users longer to download your podcast than it will other podcasts of comparable size. And finally, if you upload any files to archive.org and then want to delete them from your library, this can be a real headache. Now, the upside to hosting a podcast at archive.org. You can make your entire podcasting library available to users. There is no storage limit, there is no bandwidth limit, and hosting is free. Some additional advice. When you make the decision to commit to your podcast over the longer term, find a paid hosting site. The added benefit into user analytics is invaluable. That data can give you visibility into how many people listened to your podcast, how long they listened, where they were located, and more. Additionally, if you ever plan on picking up advertisers, you'll need that information, and you just don't get that from archive.org.